Listen up, Gunny Soaker.
B-E-A-G-G-R-E-S-S-I-V-E.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Up, kids.
Meat is for pussies, so...
Do you know about this?
Well, motherfucker.
Times be a-changing.
Heathrow Airport. I'm gonna pick her up, and obviously when you go to the pickup point, all the drivers are there with their greeting things. On this bit of activism, let's go. So this is where all the international royals are. I guess I just wait there at the end with the sign. It's good that everyone who comes into the country, whether they're coming home or on holiday, at least they get to see that, don't they? This will be fun then. It's funny because there's so many people looking at the sign, either smirking or just like straight up confused. And then there's like all the drivers who are picking up and they're looking at the sign almost like annoyed, like, that's not a name. You can't just bring your own personal sign. Just about like hundreds of people that come through and seen this. I'm always just smiling as well, so it's like positive. It's nice people smiling. You think they're obviously, it's going in some level. Yeah, I came here deliberately early. I mean, Karen won't be here for a bit, but I came here deliberately early because more people get to see it.
I don't know everything, but I have an opinion on everything. The other night, my husband and I had a pretty heated conversation about veganism. I was upset at the time. I was really upset when he said it to me first. And then I thought about it and I was like, okay, so Catherine, what are they saying? Why are you upset? They're saying you're opinionated. Are you opinionated? Yes. Is this what you wanted? Hell yes. Oh, you gave an already opinionated woman a great amount of ammunition, veganism. And if you want someone to be loud and talk about it, well then, thank you. I'm here. When I became a vegan, it was like I became a vampire and my senses were heightened and my characteristics were just like, you know, super fucking intense. You know, so many people, you meet these vegetarians and vegans who don't really have, you know, they have the opinion and I suppose they have the belief, but it's in their head and I want to talk about it. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. Damn it, I'm not going to shut up. But that pisses people off. That's like, you know, but why does it piss you off? Fucking deal with it. And you know what, in the long term, it'll actually be better. To me, it's not anger, it's passion. You know, like, I have a passion for this. And I'm glad that some people are starting to get embarrassed eating certain foods in front of me. They know that I totally disagree with it. So, moral of the story, carb the fuck up, don't eat animals, and spread the word however you see fit.
You own three things, okay? You own your fitness, you own your thoughts and emotions.
I'm doing the homeless experiment. So for the next two nights, starting from tomorrow, I'm gonna go out tomorrow morning and I'm gonna sleep two nights homeless, 3 days or whatever. Everything I put in my mouth when I'm out there homeless is gonna be coming from the money I earn as a homeless person. I'm not gonna take my wallet, I'm not gonna take my ID, I'm not gonna take any of that fucking shit. So it's legit fucking homeless. I'm gonna be the number one hustling bum cunt on the fucking planet for the next few days.
This is the first day of the homeless experience. I just got to town, it's about 9 a.m. and I'm about to start collecting cans to see how much money I can make.
I don't know if this is illegal, but I'm stealing these cunts' cans. Because when you're a homeless cunt, you do what it takes, man.
I reckon I can survive a $5 a day, yeah. $5 a day is 5 loaves of bread plus some fucking sauce. And it's not like I don't like the taste of bread and shit. Like, if I had $1 million, I'd still be eating cheap white bread. I already feel rich.
It's the worst when you're dehydrated, you have a headache, you just can't even do shit. I imagine most bums are dehydrated, don't you reckon? Because they just sit there on the fucking curb all day doing fuck all. I'm about to make a fucking dollar off this fucking dumpster. I need to go two hands in this dumpster, eh?
30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, dollar, dollar 10, 30, 40, 50, 60.
I got about $2.70 out of that.
I just found out there's no actual fucking return on these.
That makes it a bit harder. I guess, like, once you know the game, like, you know what, you can fucking recycle shit, you won't waste fucking time.
I'm just cruising to the fucking recycling place now.
So I made $5.40 there. I got the fucking receipt to prove it there. Can you see that shit, Jess?
Mm-hmm.
That's good enough for me. But right now I'm going to supermarket, I'll buy an apple or some shit.
I didn't even think I'll spend like $6, eh? I got water from, they got taps everywhere on this fucking street. Fuck, dude, this shit's got my name written all over it. I got $4 left for the whole day. Fuck it, we'll go $3.35. We'll get the small Vegemite. I'm just approaching my new home for the night.
Here we go. Fuck, man, this is the new penthouse for me.
This is the shit, bro. This is the fucking life, eh? Knock back some bread. I'm gonna look at the fucking stars tonight. First Vegemite sandwich is about to go down. See that shit? 60 fucking cents, man. So there's 310 grams of carbs, 60 grams of protein, and 13 grams of fat. So if you do the math on that, that's like... Both of us didn't do math, so... This is like a $3 fucking dinner, $4 dinner, man.
If you didn't get the fucking $3 Vegemite, dude, that would've been hell cheaper.
Yeah, but I'd like to live like a fucking king cunt. I'm not gonna buy no fucking shit Marmite, bro. But if I had to, I would. That cunt's like, dude, I can't, like, you know what I mean? Like, I can't afford to eat food and shit. So shut the fuck up, cunt.
So cheap, even, especially being vegan.
And but homeless cunts have nothing. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? Homeless cunts have nothing, bro. I know homeless cunts who smoke crack, have mobile phones, eat at restaurants every once a week.
Bums have friends, bro.
Watch some cunt comment on the thing and being like, dude, bums don't have friends.
Why be a victim, eh?
Look, I've got my own little home kitchen here. Isn't that dope? All right, guys, I just laid down in bed right now. I got my blanket, I got my spanner in case someone wants to come fight me for my spot. I'm just gonna relax my mind, convince myself I'm home, breathe, and have a good sleep. You never know, I might have the best fucking sleep of my life.
Just taking the piss. It's about fucking 3 and 2 in the morning. I've probably slept about a minute so far. Hopefully I fall asleep soon, eh?
Time goes slow, but time also goes fucking quick when you think about it. You know, it goes slow when you're sitting there like thinking, fuck, I can't sleep. Now that it's 5:30 in the morning, I'm just like, fuck, you know? It went pretty quick.
This is the view of Adelaide from halfway down Norton Summit. I can feel the weather warming up, which is good.
At 6:40 in the morning, the sun rises about 6:40, rose about a minute ago. I'll probably just chill in town for a bit. I'll have the whole afternoon free to collect cans.
With $6, bro, you can do pretty much any diet on the planet. In terms of the vegan diet, it's so easy being a bum and being on a vegan diet. You know what I mean? You can't be a bum eating fucking T-bone, $8 fucking New York strip steaks and shit. What you can do is be a fucking bum eating loaves of bread and Vegemite, living like a fucking king.
30. 40, 60.
It's actual fucking payday, hey. That was like 60 cents pay for less than a minute's work, hey. I'm cleaning up off the big corporations, mate. So you want to do cardio, just walk around and get paid for it, man. This is the official receipt for day two. Today I made $9.60. Hustling, making cans, and training, and riding around on my... That's a super bum. I'm a super bum, bro. I'm a super bum. Just went past the Nike shop. There's a bunch of cunts out the front of the Nike shop waiting for a brand new pair of shoes. What happened was I went up to this guy, bro, and I was like, hey, bro, when are the shoes coming out? Oh, it's coming out in 2 days.
What's the world fucking coming to, mate?
I'm gonna set up camp just here.
All right, it's been a fucking long day, so I'm gonna try and get some fucking rest. Good night, Glucose Nation. You know the fucking drill, mate. If I fucking die, bro, cereal was my favorite fucking food, and I almost finished university, and I was a fucking star student, and I was gonna do mechanical, chemical engineers, build fucking satellites and all that shit.
If you're not pissing clear, you're living in fear. The stars and shit are so bizarre, dude. There's definitely aliens out there. Fuck all you cunts who think there's no aliens, bro. Birds up here won't shut the fuck up. Hey, bro, do you reckon you could shut up, please?
Being homeless in society is like one step away from like just dying. The shittest place you can be is homeless. You have nothing. So what you're left with is your internal stuff, your fitness, your thoughts and emotions. Everything external is stripped from you. Walking around all day to collect money to eat food and then riding it to the fucking recycling thing involves fitness. The way you perceive your situation, the way you think about being homeless is going to be reflected in your actions. If you don't own your thoughts, you go off what everyone else says, that being homeless is the worst thing in the world and you should be very sad about it. You turn into a victim. When you don't own your thoughts, someone else controls your actions. Before you know it, I'll be holding a sign on the side of the street saying, hey, I'm Abdullah, I'm a Muslim Arab cunt. My mum kicked me out of the house and I can't be fuck working and can't be fuck recycling cans. So just give me money and this is my dog and I feel sympathetic for my dog, so give me money. But if you own your thoughts and emotions, you sit there and you say, who gives a fuck, man? And you hustle and you start fucking recycling cans and you own your thoughts, therefore you own your actions and you decide the path you're gonna walk. You don't let someone else decide it. When you own your thoughts, you own your actions and you control your actions. The lowest point, you turn it into the biggest fucking positive of your life. Bootcat anthem, what you want, the pretenders,
yeah. I'll stop you in your tracks if you start with me. So when you hear the word vegan, what comes to your mind? What's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Not this.
Not this? Okay.
Pretentious, actually, is what came to mind for
pretentious?
Me.
Pretentious?
Yeah.
What makes you feel like that?
I come from Byron Bay, so okay.
There's a lot of vegans?
Yeah, it's just a pain in the ass.
And just as many pretentious people.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, you think they're mostly vegan or pretentious? Or?
They're just the kind of people that just go around kind of preaching stuff like that. It's like, let me enjoy my full-fat coffee and my steak.
What's worse, preaching to humans or killing innocent animals?
That's an awesome question. I'm not going to answer it.
Yeah. Nah.
Cool.
Thanks.
Thanks, guys.
Became vegan recently, right?
It's been about a year and 9 months now.
How is it?
I like not eating meat.
Yeah. Oh, I think it's a wonderful thing.
I like
but do
not
you
eating
not
meat.
Just miss, like, you know, bacon?
Oh, vegan.
I gotta go vegan.
Vegan.
I gotta go
get
vegan.
Back to go vegan.
Hang on, is this a new Stevie Wonder vegan. Classic? Go vegan. Go vegan. I love it. We've just made a Stevie Wonder original, right? Baby, everything is alright. Uptight, clean inside.
I once thought they were crazy, malnourished, extreme. How self-righteous elitist can an individual be? Why not just respect my beliefs? I respect yours, can't you see? I don't harass you guys about refraining from eating any dairy or meat. And then one day I met a nice man and I was completely shocked to find out that he was one of these crazy ass vegans that I was just talking about. I just couldn't believe it. He seemed way too normal, not patronizing, angry, or extreme. He then asked me a question that completely changed my perception on the world that I had once seen. He said, if you could live a life that was filled with health, happiness, and success too, without causing harm to any other beings, then tell me, why wouldn't you? I went home and thought about this question. I thought about it for days. I came up with every possible excuse to clear my guilt and to justify my previous ways. So I went back to this man and I did what I could to try to prove him wrong. But humans need meat, our ancestors ate them, we need protein to keep us strong. And how is milk cruel? And what about eggs? If we didn't shear sheep, they would die. And leather is fine, the cow's already dead, vegan food is too expensive, I cried. Each question I presented was calmly refuted using only true logic and facts. I soon found out that all of my arguments were unfortunately full of holes and cracks. So I did further research and finally decided to become something I had never planned. I took responsibility for my existence, I made a choice, I used my voice, I made a vote, and I took a stand. And once you get this voice, it's like learning to speak again. You soon boil over with passion. You want to tell everyone, you want them to see it, to feel it, to also take action. You want them to stand beside you, to see what you see, to be a part of this incredible movement. There is nothing extreme about choosing life over death. We're equal, us animals and humans. I've now been on both sides. Vegans are stereotyped as preachy, but what has been brought to light is that they just want you to see veganism for what it really is. It's about equality and what's wrong and right. They are here to help you if you decide that you want to make a change too. We want you on our team. We're not as crazy as we seem. If you give it a chance, you'll see what's true.
To anyone. My name is Emmy, and as of today, I am 25 years, 32 weeks, and 4 days old. For 25 years and 5 weeks, I killed. This is my apology to those lives I took. Enslaved, raped, tortured, killed. I contributed not only to destroying lives, but that of our environment and of the planet. I'm sorry I drank, chewed, and swallowed the product of rape, castration, and body part removal. I'm sorry for believing that I needed to drink milk that was intended for your babies, the babies I helped take away from you shortly after you gave birth to them. I'm sorry I paid people to rip your skin so I could have a nice bag. I'm sorry I blindly believed the lies they told me and didn't stop to think that these industries have enough money in their wallets to pay the media, research facilities, and anyone else necessary to bring people against you. I didn't write this letter expecting forgiveness from you. I write you today to tell you that there is hope. There are so many of us fighting the fight out here right now. They're fighting for your freedom, and the numbers are growing by the day, with the hopes that one day, the future generation, living in a world where all of us are vegan, can look back and see what you went through and how far the human race has come from here. I hope this letter will be heard by the generation that truly appreciates you, your life, and honors your sacrifice. My name is Emmy, and as of today, I am 25 years, 32 weeks, and 4 days old, and I am no longer contributing to animal cruelty.
When me tell them say that I'm a vegan man, how when me eat, them I wonder when me eat. When me tell them say me no eat no fish nor no meat now, how when me eat, them I wonder when me yum. When me tell them say that I'm a vegan.
Okay, so here's how this is gonna work, folks. I'm gonna broadcast this event in short chunks because all told, it's gonna take a while.
Okay. All right, I got a lot of work to do now. There's kind of no stopping me now. We definitely have their attention. Come on, Sammy.
There's the cops.
We got lots of fire trucks, tons of cops.
And we got Sammy.
Should I light the artillery shells? The helicopter's not that close, right? Woo! This is fucking chaos!
Didn't put my foot down from Shamu.
Yeah, Shamu! I did it for you!
What's your plan?
Well, my plan is if they want to arrest me, I'll go on a meditation retreat.
Why did you do it?
Why did I do it?
Yeah.
Because it was the right thing to do, man. SeaWorld sucks.
If doing that was wrong, I don't want to be right. Screw you, SeaWorld! Woo!
Yeah!
Yeah, dude. You fucked the system. Like a
boss. So who's number one this week?
It's the Henya.
Hey, maniacs, it's Henya, and welcome to another video. Gary, you're rocking, man. Best bitch you've ever heard. About time to realize your vision has been blurred.
This is vegan style. Vegan style. Oh, 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 oh. This is vegan style. Vegan style.
So if you guys are not familiar with whatever's going on the internet right now, then good for you, because it's really annoying. Lately on Instagram and YouTube, people started coming out saying that they're not fully vegan and that they enjoy a plant-based diet. I'm gonna fucking ruin my fingers today. They enjoy having some animal products once in a while. They like going to the zoo and take pictures of their kids with animals that have been sedated with drugs and stuff like that. You know, all the good stuff in life. But for some reason, they don't just like to keep it to themselves. They just like to share it with the whole world that they're complete shit cunts. They feel the urge to put the message out there that it's okay to hurt animals once in a while or every now and again. They need the reassurance and affirmations from their followers that they're alright, that they're doing fine. They're doing all they can to help the animals within the limits that they have. Fuck them. Seriously? All these cunts are just looking for other people's approval for the shit things that they do, and they know it's shit. All those people be like, oh, I'm really sorry, I should have called myself plant-based. I'm really sorry I hurt you, my followers. Newsflash. It's not about you or your followers, it's about the animals that we're getting pissed about. Plant-based is just a fucking excuse for you to continue hurting animals. And I know a lot of you guys still view it as a diet and not as a lifestyle or a philosophy. Take the time to understand the ethical aspects of it. It's fine, like, you don't even have to be an activist. But don't go around and tell your followers that it's fine to go to the zoo and take a photo with a sedated tiger or to eat a cookie that has butter in it. You're giving out approval to other people to hurt animals. What the fuck is wrong with you? Why on earth would you do such a thing? Like, seriously, if you guys choose to hurt animals, something is seriously fucked up with you. And just the fact that you don't see it in your own eyes or that you didn't do it in your own hands doesn't mean that it's not happening. So please, please, get out of your own asses and do something for someone else. Anyone can go vegan. All you need to do is decide. I will not participate in animal cruelty. That's all it takes. From that point on, your resolution will take you to wherever you need to go. Love some of you. Mwah! Bye.
This is vegan style.
That's the fucking video. You know the drill. Like, share, comment, subscribe, share with your mum, share with your sister, share with your boyfriend, share with your spouse. We support Game Manager. I hope you do follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube. Shout out to my boy, fucking H. I'll see you on the fucking tube tomorrow. Like, peace.
Damn it. I'm not going to shut up. Like, oh.
Go vegan. Yeah. Go vegan. That's damn about to go vegan.
Yeah, dude.
Be aggressive. Beaggressive.